Hello and welcome back to Studio Shepherd. In today's tutorial, I'm going to be using generative AI to create these 3D text effects. And so, if you haven't already seen, Adobe has released Firefly Beta, which uses generative AI-powered tools for content creation. So we're going to be using a mix of Adobe Firefly and Photoshop to create these effects today. And so to begin, go to firefly.adobe.com. And then we're going to be working with text to image and text effects today. And so we want to start off with text effects. So just hit generate. And it's going to take you to this dashboard with a bunch of examples I've created. And so I quite like the look of this colorful shaggy fur. And so I'm just going to hit try prompt. And it's going to take you to the screen. And here's where we can make some changes. So I'm going to change the text to say fuzzy. And you can change the match shape from tight, medium, or loose. And this is just how much the effect expands over the edges. So for example, the fur here. So how much the fur is going to extrude from the text. And I'm going to change the font to poplar. And then make sure to set your background color to transparent. And as you can see, it's going to generate these four different variations to work from. And if you don't like any of those variations, you can go down and hit refresh, and it's going to create four more for you. So I quite like the look of this one. And so when you're happy, you can go up, hover over your image, and hit download. And now once that's done, we're going to go back and back again, and we're going to select the text to image. And as you can see, it's going to show a whole bunch of examples that other people have created. But what we want to do in this text bar here is add the same prompt that we used for our text. So I'm going to put in colorful shaggy fur. And again, it's going to generate four different options for us to choose from. And we're just going to adjust some of the settings here. So the aspect ratio, we want to set to widescreen, so 16:9. And so I like the look of this one, and it looks like it's going to match the text quite well. So again, hover over and hit download. And now we're going to jump across to Photoshop. And so I've opened up Photoshop and added our two images that we've created. And so first up, as you can see, we just need to adjust the outline of our text. And so go to your layers panel and then hold command or control and click your text. And we're going to hit create mask. And so with that mask selected, double click. And we're going to refine this edge with the refine hairbrush tool. So if you zoom in with your brush, just trace it along the edges. And as you can see, it's going to refine our text here. Hit OK when you're done. And now we can just grab the paintbrush tool and have it set to black. And I'm just going to get rid of the Adobe Firefly watermark. So once that's done, I'm going to give our text layer a bevel, and this is going to help it sink into the background. And so double click your text layer, and we're going to tick bevel and emboss. And then if you click bevel and emboss, you can adjust these settings in here. So make sure it's set to outer bevel. The technique I've got set to smooth. You can change the depth of your bevel to whatever you like, and just make sure the direction is set to down, and this is going to make sure it's sinking into the background rather than sitting on top of it. And you can play around with your size here to whatever looks right and adjust your highlights and shadows. And when you're happy, hit OK. And now for our final step, you can either leave it like this, or what I like to do is change the blend mode of our text layer. So go up to our blend settings and go down and change it to luminosity. And as you can see, that's going to pull through the background colors, and that's going to make our furry text layer help blend into the background. And there you have it. Now you can get creative and play around with different prompts to see what other cool effects you can create. As always, thanks for watching. If you found this helpful, be sure to like and subscribe, and keep an eye out for the next video. See you next time.